Many people think that the Polish astronomer Nicolaus Copernicus was the first one to propose that the Sun is the center of our solar system. Well, he wasn't the first one to express that idea, but his ideas did cause a global paradigm shift among astronomers and cosmologists. After Copernicus had published his book on the revolutions of the heavenly spheres in 1543, the vast majority of the scientific community stepped away from the idea that the Earth was the center of our solar system. But it was the Greek astronomer Aristarchus of Samos who phrased the first known proposal for a model of the cosmos, putting the Sun in the center of everything around 280 BC. But not many people in the scientific community followed the ideas of Aristarchus. Aristarchus was centuries ahead of his time, and society, science, and especially religion were not ready yet for his revolutionary idea, because didn't God intend it for the Earth to be a very special place? Didn't God first create the heavens and the earth in the beginnings, before creating the sun and the stars, indicating that the earth surely was the center of it all? Between Aristarchus and Copernicus, it took humanity more than 18 centuries to finally let go of the idea that the earth was the center of the universe. As of 1543, the heliocentric model of Copernicus took the world by storm, firmly establishing a totally different vision on our universe. Finally, humanity embraced the idea that Earth is just a planet that revolves around its local star that we call the Sun. And seen from that perspective, Earth is just the third rock from the Sun, revolving around its local star, just like a trillion other planets in the universe. To us, Earth might look very special because it's the place where we live and it's the only place we have. But to the cosmos, Earth is just the same as any other planet.